everyone, welcome to a new video. Today I'm going to show you my TBR for the 2019 Magical Owls readathon. So the Magical Owls or OWLs readathon is a Harry Potter inspired readathon that is organized by G from Book Roast. And I mean Harry Potter inspired readathon, that sounds perfect to me because, as you may know, I do very much like Harry Potter. I participated in this readathon last year as well and I really enjoyed it. The idea is basically that you pick a book for every Harry Potter subject or every Hogwarts subject. So you basically do exams or OWLs for every subject with reading a book with a certain challenge or prompt. There are 12 subjects, so 12 prompts and 12 books. I will leave a link to G's video, announcement video down below in the description box because she has all the details and the challenges, and also she has made this amazing sort of wizarding career booklet. I haven't really chosen a career yet, maybe I will do that later, but please check her video out and she has put so much work and so much effort into this and it's amazing. Oh yeah, and also this readathon takes place during the entire month of April, so you have an entire month to finish as many exams as possible. But yeah, I think that's enough for an introduction. Let's just get started with my TBR and then I'm going to show you the books that I've picked for my owls in 2019. The first subject is Ancient Runes, and for this subject you have to read a retelling. And for this I have chosen Mythos by Stephen Fry. This is not really a fiction retelling of like an old story in the traditional sense, but it does literally say the Greek myths retold, so definitely a good book for this challenge. And yeah, that's pretty much what this book is, I believe. It's Stephen Fry retelling the Greek myths, and I don't know like if he sort of changes them or not, I really don't know, but this book has been everywhere, like in so many bookstores. And I have been wanting to read it for a while. I love Greek mythology. And yeah, I just really love that this is the perfect book for this challenge. I also have the audiobook, and that is actually narrated by Stephen Fry, so I'm not sure yet if I'm going to read the physical book or the audiobook. Stephen Fry does have an amazing voice, so yeah, maybe I will change it up, but very excited about this one and hopefully I will love it. The next subject is Arithmancy, a work written by more than one author. For this I have picked Gemina by Amy Kaufman and Jay Kristoff. This is the second book in the Illuminae Files series. It's this sort of series that is told in documents, so like transcriptions and emails and everything. It is amazing. I've read Illuminae about a year ago and it's really time that I get on with the sequel. And also this book is the only one in my entire TBR at the moment that has more than one author, so I sort of had to pick this one, but I also like that this is the perfect excuse to finally pick it up. And again, not sure if I might be listening to the audiobook a little bit, because the audiobook with the Illuminae Files are really, really good. But yeah, again, hopefully I will love it. And if it's as good as the first one, then I'm sure I will. The next subject is astronomy. Read a book with the word star in the title. For this, I have chosen Nora and Kettle by Lauren Nicole Taylor. And I can hear you thinking, there's no star in this title. That's right, but I've checked my entire bookcase, all my TBR books. I do not have a single book with the word star in it. But this book does have the undertitle of a Paper Stars novel, so this is the closest I'm going to get. I believe that's sort of like a book series or whatever, I'm not sure, but it does have stars like very small written here, so you know, that's the best thing I'm going to get right now. Nora and Kettle is a sort of Peter Pan retelling, and it's also historical fiction. It takes place shortly after World War II, I believe. This book has been recommended to me ages ago and I still haven't read it. It's not too big, so again, perfect opportunity to finally read it, and it's the only book that sort of qualifies for this challenge. The next subject is Care of Magical Creatures, and the challenge is to read a book with a land animal on the cover. For this I have picked A Skinful of Shadows by Frances Harding, and as you can see it has bears on the cover, so land animal, also birds, they're more like air animals, but you know, this cover is perfect. I don't know much about the plot. I believe it's sort of about spirits and it's very spiritual, and it's about like communicating with the dead. I'm really not sure, but it does have some good reviews, and again, a book that has been on my TBR for ages. And if I can, I will try to read it this month, and also the cover is so pretty And I hope I'll love it. And yeah, I'm just very excited to read it again. And yeah, I'm not sure if I'm going to read all of these books, but I'm going to try. The next subject is charms, and the prompt is age line, read an adult novel. So of course, that's a very easy one. I have lots of adult novels. For this one, I've picked Empress of Rome by Kate Quinn. This is the sort of sequel to Mistress of Rome by Kate Quinn that I read last year, which I enjoyed very much. I don't have a physical copy of this book, but I have an ebook. I have it on my e-reader, so yeah. At the moment, this is the book I'm going to choose, but you know, since this is a very easy challenge, I can maybe switch it up if I really feel like reading another book. But yeah, Empress of Rome, it does not take place after Mistress of Rome. It's actually sort of a prequel. It's about more people during the ancient Roman Empire, and I'm not completely sure about the plot. I believe it's about a couple of women and, yeah, you know, emperors and power and everything. I just really enjoyed Mistress of Rome, so I'm sure this one will be enjoyable as well. Next we have Defense Against the Dark Arts, that is Reducto, title starts with an R. And for this I have chosen Roar by Cora Carmack. This is a book that was in a fairy loot box a very long time ago, and again, a book that has been sitting on my shelves for quite some time. I feel that's definitely the theme of this TBR video. But anyway, again, I don't know much about the plot, but I believe it's very much inspired by sort of elemental magic. And it's about a princess named Aurora, and yeah, I don't know much about it. It's fantasy, and yeah, that's pretty much it. And I don't even know that many reviews about this book, to be honest. I haven't heard a lot of people talk about it. But it's also, again, the only book on my TBR at the moment that starts with an R, so you know, I didn't have a lot of choice in the matter. Next we have Divination, read a book that is set in the future. For this it's going to be a reread, and it's going to be a reread of Sight by Neil Schusterman. This is one of my favorite books last year. It's incredible, it's so good. And this book is set in the future. It's actually set in the future of Earth, and it's based in this future where death and disease are all fixed, they're no longer a thing. But then you do have sides who still have to kill people to sort of keep the population under control and everything. And yeah, it's amazing, I loved it so much. And that's why I decided to reread it. And I think I might listen to the audiobook with this one, because I love to reread books through audiobook. So yeah, very excited to experience this story again, and I know I'm going to love it because I loved it the first time around. The next subject is Herbology, read a book with a plant on the cover. For this I have chosen The Immortalists by Chloe Benjamin. This book is about four siblings who learn the date of their deaths, and then it follows them throughout their lives. As you can see, it has a sort of tree on the cover, so that counts as a plant. And I've heard some mixed reviews about this book. I'm not completely sure, but I really love the premise, so I really hope I will love the story. But yeah, I'm going to have to figure it out and see if I'm going to like it. And yeah, I hope I do, but you know, I'll guess I have to read it to see. Then we have History of Magic, read a book that was published at least 10 years ago. And this is going to be another reread, and it's going to be my reread of Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire by J.K. Rowling. And this was definitely published more than 10 years ago. I believe it's almost 20 years ago. I believe it was published in the year 2000. Not completely sure, but of course I grew up with this series, and yeah, it has been a long time since this book came out. Goblet of Fire is my absolute favorite of the entire series. I love it so much, and I cannot wait to reread it again. And of course, I'm still doing all my video reviews of every single Harry Potter book. I know it has been a while since I did my review for Prisoner of Azkaban, but now I'm finally going to pick up Goblet of Fire, and then there will be a new video review. And it worked out perfectly with this challenge for this readathon. So I have to read it this month, and I'm so excited, and I love this book so much. Cannot wait to love it again. For the subject Muggle Studies, you have to read a contemporary book. Again, quite easy, and for now I have chosen the Rosie Result by Graham Simsion. I've read the Rosie Project and the Rosie Effect quite a while ago, and at the time I really enjoyed them. And now there is a new book, and it takes place about 10 years after the second book. And you know, I am curious to see what I'm going to think of it. And it is a contemporary, so you know, maybe it will be nothing, because I don't know. I don't know if I still love the first book that much, because I've never reread it. But you know, it's fine to check it out. And again, a contemporary is quite easy to get by, so I can always change it if I don't like it. But hopefully I will sort of enjoy it. And yeah, also this book series is about a man named Don Tillman. who probably has like some form of autism. And then he sort of starts this project to meet his perfect wife, and then he meets Rosie, who in every way is not his perfect wife, and yeah, it's sort of like his life story. Then we have potions, and the challenge is to read a sequel as a next ingredient. And for this I have chosen The Son of Neptune by Rick Riordan. This is the second book in the Heroes of Olympus series. I'm currently reading the first book, which is The Last Hero, and I'm very much enjoying it. I still love this world and this writing style. And for those of you who don't know, Rick Riordan's books are about our world, but also about the Greek myths and the Greek gods, and also the Roman gods in this series, who are actually real, and half-bloods or demigods are real. So yeah, this will be a perfect sequel. It's very enjoyable, at least the first book is so far, and I cannot wait to dive into it. And then the final subject is Transfiguration, and the challenge is to read a book with sprayed edges or with red on the cover. And for this, I have picked The Familiars by Stacey Halls. And as you can see, sprayed pages, so it fits. And this book is a historical fiction book, and it's about a woman who's had a couple of miscarriages, and now she's pregnant again, and she has a new midwife. Don't know really what happens after that, but it sounded interesting. And of course, I love historical fiction, and it is gorgeous, this edition. It has sprayed pages, and that makes it perfect to do my exam for Transfiguration. So yeah, that was it for my TBR for the Owls Magical Readathon 2019. Very excited. I'm going to do my very best to manage all of these challenges. I don't know if it's actually going to work out, and April is quite a busy month, but you know, I can try. And I love how this sort of motivates to read some books that have been on my TBR for a while, and you know, hopefully it will go well, and yeah, I'm just very excited for it. And this was it now for this video. If you like this video, please go subscribe, or maybe give it a thumbs up, because I would really appreciate that. And hopefully I will see you again very soon in my next video. Bye!